arm of the Lord been revealed. He grew up before him like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground, he had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him. Nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering. Like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by men and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. Let us pray. Father in heaven, as we read that prophecy of Jesus' birth and Jesus coming and Jesus dying on the cross for us, written thousands of years before he came by the prophet Isaiah, we look at that and say, wow, Christ fulfilled prophecy. And that's what we're here to do today, Lord, is celebrate the prophecy that Jesus would come, die on a cross, and on the third day rise again from the grave, so that we could have eternal life with him. We thank you and praise you for this truth. I pray that our hearts would be turned towards you now, Lord, as we sing praise to you in song and worship you. And Lord, as we listen to a message by Chaplain Luter later, I pray that we would leave here refreshed in our spirits, ready to serve you. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Nate? If you'd like to stand as we sing, Let Heaven Rejoice. peace of God from above, let us pray to the Lord. Your response will be, hear us, O Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the peace, unity, and faithful service of the churches of God in this and every land.
Stopping hell's oppressor.